Yes, that was our new mayor-elect, Eddie Melton, from his campaign headquarters after winning the primary in May against our current sitting mayor, Jerome Prince. The elections of 2023 here had consequence. At the very beginning, I was not sure anybody would pick off Jerome Prince and be able to take him out, for the simple fact that I thought most people would give him the benefit of the doubt. He became the mayor as soon as the pandemic, well, right before the pandemic started. He was essentially a pandemic era mayor. And so I thought a lot of people would say, look, let's just let the man see what he's going to do with the ARPA funds. Let's see what's going to happen in regards to all the new construction and things that are being built here in the city, and Hard Rock and all this stuff. Let's see how everything starts to shake out before we switch horses in the middle of the race. But it was pretty much a runaway for the mayor-elect, Eddie Melton, who I've had the pleasure of meeting a few times. He's always been very nice to me. A good brother overall. Mayor Jerome Prince has always been good to me as well. I've always said, and when the Rev was here, I think we both agreed that we were in good hands regardless. I supported Mayor Prince, and I support Mayor Melton 100% because I support Gary, Indiana. Now, if you guys know, I keep it real. You guys know who I do. I don't support, you know, a lot of people that everybody else supports. I'm not a shrinking violet. I definitely will make controversial statements and not support who I don't support. But I truly believe that we were in good hands either way. I really would have liked to have seen Mayor Prince get a COVID-free a COVID-free term. I really hate that his entire term was eaten up by the pandemic. I think that the pandemic has distorted reality in a lot of ways. And as life gets back to normal, we're already seeing things starting to sort of even out and shake out. We're going to talk about this in the next year, probably next week or the week after next. Some good news is that violent crime plummeted this year. It really did. It was the biggest single year drop in recorded history. All the sort of spike in crime we had during the pandemic, gone. Like I kind of felt it would. We saw 30 years of crime declining from the mid-90s until the mid to late 20-teens, basically from the Clinton era through the end of the Obama era, early Trump era. We saw 30 years of crime decline, and then when the pandemic hit, it shot up, due to the sort of artificial environment of the moment, whether it was the pandemic and people losing their jobs, people losing their homes, people having fatigue of the virus and sort of being afraid and being in a heightened state and hypervigilant, or the George Floyd protest and the sort of reckoning with police brutality. Between those two things, it was obvious that crime was artificially spiking during 2020, 2021, 2022. Now we see that basically we're returning to where we were in 2019 as a society, which was just sort of where, like, in a general, a much safer time than, say, the mid-90s when I grew up here in the murder capital of America. So I would like to have seen Mayor Prince get a COVID-free term. I'd like to see what Mayor Melton does. with this COVID-free term. I'm excited that he is bringing in people, a lot of different movers and shakers from around the country, some famous, some not. He seems to have a lot of people backing him. Maybe that will be good for the city of Gary. Whatever it is, anything that's good for the city of Gary, I support it 100%. So, you know, I'm more than happy to have Mayor Eddie Melton as my mayor. Seems like a good brother. Him and his wife seem like really good people. And also, you know, thank you to Mayor Jerome Prince. Like I said, a class act. Always supportive of us here at WLTH. Me, specifically, our organization, United Urban Network. Very good brother. Hopefully, you know, whatever he chooses to do after this brings him happiness and success. But that is number four, the 2023 election. Also, I want to give a shout out to William Godwin, who lost his primary at-large primary as well. But he has definitely landed on his feet. If you've been following him on Facebook, he's definitely landed on his feet, all right. So, you know, simultaneously, tough break. And congratulations, brother. And congratulations to everyone else on the Common Council out in East Chicago. My cousin. I had two cousins who were elected in East Chicago. Congratulations to them. Congratulations to Mayor Copeland, who won his primary as well and won the election there as well. Also, McDermott. So, the number four most important issue of 2023, at least here, was the 2023 elections, the primaries and the elections. It is time for number three. Oh, man. We're about to really get it started here. The number three most important news story of 2023 is immigration, particularly illegal immigration, mass immigration, should I say. Mass immigration is turning out to be one of the biggest issues, not just here in this country, but in the world. We are seeing seismic political shifts all over the world due to all these different migrants coming from Africa, from Latin America. And let me just tell you, as climate change seemingly gets worse, we're just beginning, folks. We have just begun here. 10,000 illegal immigrants are pouring across the southern border every day here in the United States. In 2023, a historic 2.5 million migrants crossed the U.S.-Mexico border. Now, maybe next week, I don't know, maybe in a few weeks, we're going to get into exactly why this is being allowed to happen. I'm just going to give you a quick preview as why this is being allowed to happen. It's called the military-industrial complex. They are not meeting their quotas. There's not enough people who want to sign up to possibly fight World War III against Russia and China and Iran. So, you know, and I'm not saying this because I think this. I'm saying this because I've got actual people in Congress who said this out loud on the floor of Congress. So these people are not dumb. They're not incompetent. They know what they're doing. They don't care about your standard of living being degraded by having millions of low-wage, low-skilled workers coming here to compete for jobs and resources with you and me or anybody else. The only thing that matters is the military-industrial complex. That is what runs this country. Them and Wall Street, the banksters. You know, if we don't do something about that, then we won't have a country. All right, folks, let's get to number two, the most important stories, news stories of 2023. Number two is inflation. Yes, everything costs too damn much. It does. I'm sorry. I go to the store every week to go grocery shopping, and everything I used to buy costs more than, well, everything I buy costs more than it did before this Ukrainian conflict. I used to buy hamburger for $7.99. It went up to $9.99. Now it's $12.99. You go, wait, what? If I buy oatmeal, it started off as $2.19. A big package of oatmeal, I'd get it for $2.19. Now it's about $4. Virtually everything I buy, chicken, anything, everything, costs a lot. Rice costs a lot more. Like, everything costs so much now. And it is definitely something that's going to have an effect. As I've done the story here, and you can look on my YouTube channel, Scott Cannon WLTH. I just did the story a few weeks ago about what actually caused that inflation. And I'll just say two words to you. Corporate greed. Yeah, that's basically what caused most of it. Corporate greed. But yeah, you can look the video up on my YouTube channel, Scott Cannon WLTH. The segment, it's right there in a nice little package for you. But yes, inflation, you have particularly people in my generation, millennials and Zoomers. We have now come to the realization that we will never be able to buy our own homes. A lot of us will never be able to buy our own homes. A lot of us are stuck with debt, generational debt. You have a lot of millennials with hundreds of thousands of dollars of college debt. And this is definitely going to also be a very important factor in our politics in the future. One thing, I'm not the biggest Tucker Carlson fan in the world, but one thing he got 100% right was when he said, whoever finds a way to allow Americans to get married and own a home and, you know, live a good life, or at least what was traditionally seen as the American dream, that's who's going to win politics here in this country. If you are not focused on that, how are you going to get your young people, your marriage age people, your working age people married in productive employment and, you know, stable? You're going to have to figure that out. That you're going to have to figure out. If you're not doing that, you shouldn't be in politics here in this country. But unfortunately, our government is pretty much only good at funneling money to the military-industrial complex in Wall Street and Big Pharma. That's about it. All right, folks, we got to go to a break. It is 8:08. It's the top of the hour. So I got one more story here. You're going to have to stick around and see what it is, where we figure out what is the most important news story of the year 2023. Be right back after these. That is Money by Barrett Strong, one of the great songwriters, one of the great songs of the 20th century. We lost Barrett Strong this year in the year 2023. So we're going to, you know, wish him, we're going to say rest in peace to him and wish his family well. This is My Country with Scott Cannon, the year 2023 in review, folks. Yes, we're deep into the 8 o'clock hour. It is 8:11 p.m. We are currently counting down the most important news stories of the year 2023. Number 10 was U.S. Steel being sold to the Japanese. Number 9 was labor unions rising. Yes. Number 8 was Africa on the rise and on the move. Number 7 was the end of the COVID-19 pandemic. Number 6 was the Russia-Ukraine conflict. Number 5 was artificial intelligence deepfakes. I'm telling you guys, this will have a huge effect on politics and our culture in the near future. Already is starting to. Number 4, the 2023 elections, namely here in Gary, Eddie Melton unseating our incumbent mayor, Mayor Jerome Prince. Number 3 was immigration, millions of illegal immigrants flooding across our southern border, damaging the quality of life for American people, working class American people. Number 2 was inflation, everything costs too doggone much. And number 1, I guess you could probably figure out what it is since I haven't said it yet. And the number 1 most important news story of 2023 is the Israeli-Palestinian conflict that has gone into overdrive in the last 2 months. We've seen this particular conflict inflame passions in the Middle East to a state that we have not seen in many, many years. This could have serious, serious consequences in the future. Obviously, we know on October 7th, Hamas staged an attack against Israelis. A lot of people died. We've heard it was 1,200. Now we know that a lot of those people were killed by Israel itself. You know, that's why they're trying to bury the evidence. A lot of those cars in the desert that were actually shot up by helicopters, Israeli helicopters. But still, nonetheless, the people who were killed, they are still dead. You know, whether they were killed by Hamas or Israel themselves, it's unfortunate and tragic. Obviously, this is open old wounds about not just what's been going on recent years with the settlements in the West Bank and other skirmishes that have taken place, but going all the way back to 1948, the Nakba, when almost 1 million Palestinians were basically forced off of their land. And hell, some of this even going back to the sort of the Bible days, the biblical times. So this has turned into a really, really taxing situation. As I speak, over 20,000 Palestinians have been killed. Gaza is pretty much non-existent at this point. You know, Israel is telling people where the people, the supposedly the innocent people to go, and then bombing where the innocent people are. We've seen countless videos, pictures of dead children. 70% of the people who've been killed thus far have been women and children. So not the Hamas fighters that Israel says that they are attacking. This has just turned into an overall ugly conflict, and one that I believe will have major, major ramifications on the year 2024 and maybe the years after that. All right, folks, thank you for sticking with us through this countdown of the most important news stories of the year 2023. We're going to take a break really quick, but when we get back, we're going to talk about the people we lost in the year 2023. It's a pretty long list. We'll be right back after these.